Incredible, aren't they? I mean, sure, they look the part. But just wait till we get them out there. Trust me, you're gonna see things from a whole new perspective.
Right, our racing game isn't selling too well anymore. What can we do to improve it? How about physics-defying roads in the sky and giant-ass dinosaurs? Give this man a damn medal. This is Forza Horizon 3's Hot Wheels expansion. Now, I have to admit, as a kid, I never really got behind the whole Hot Wheels craze, mainly because my parents never bought me a track. So when I first got into this DLC, I was honestly more excited about getting the Zonda R than about the tracks themselves.
Oh, you touch my tra-la-la. My ding-ding-dong.
Then I started driving around and holy jeebus! Without even knowing it, this is what I've been waiting for all this time. Forza always had a soft spot in my heart for allowing me to pretty much build anything I want, but taking those same cars to do all kinds of crazy stunts, loops and jumps and whatever races and just nothing short of amazing. I mean, just look at this. And then of course I discovered the barn find. Barn finds are old abandoned cars that you find in, well, a barn. It's a Ford from 1932. I mean, it looks pretty nice, I guess, but it's pretty underwhelming, really. Well, that is until you realize that this is one of the most customizable cars in the game. The one you're seeing right now, that looks mostly stock, it's got a 1000 horsepower V8 swapped into it. One thing I have to warn you of, however, is that if you are going to drive this car on the upside down loops, you will need to get some downforce, else you just fly right off the track. Besides the crazy Ford and the sexy, sexy Zonda, you also get four Hot Wheels cars that are as ridiculous as they look. The Twin Mill in particular is quite fun to try and drive around and drive you. And by funny, I pretty much mean impossible.
What is that? What the fuck is that?
Now personally I don't really bother too much with the races themselves and instead just derp around flying off of ramps at 200 miles per hour. I can see this maybe getting boring after a while, but then again I can just take my Hot Rod Ford into the regular game and turn it into an awesome dirt car. So the question is, should you buy Forza Horizon 3 and the Hot Wheels expansion? No, absolutely not. Let me explain. If you already have Forza Horizon 3 and either an Xbox or a very, very high-end PC with an Xbox controller, then by all means, go for it. The game is really fun. But if you don't have an Xbox and instead just have a mediocre PC, don't even bother. Whilst you can play this game on Windows 10, even though it is an Xbox game, it is horribly optimized for PC. You need an insanely good CPU and very fast RAM to ever reach 60 FPS, even with a very good graphics card, which is kinda important in such a fast-paced game. Oh, and don't even bother with the Ultimate Edition, it doesn't come with these DLC. But problems aside, this is a game I keep coming back to when I'm getting fed up with War Thunder. And you know, when I'm sick and tired of crashing into the trees in War Thunder, I can always do a couple of nice things in this game. If you have liked this video and you would like to see more Forza Horizon 3, let me know in the comment section down below. I'd also like to thank everyone who's joined our community Discord. We now have over 1000 members and got accepted as a partner. I won't be advertising the Discord anymore on videos since I don't want it to overflow, honestly. But if you want to join, there will be a link in every video description. Anyways lads, I'll see you next time. My name's Mikey's Boom, and thank you for watching. You can lift your head up to the sky, take a deeper breath and give it time. You can walk the path among the lies with your shattered frame of mind. But instead you could always stay. We can wait right here and play until somehow you can find